So, hello guys. In this lesson, we will talk about osteosarcomas in dogs. So, the osteosarcoma is the most common primary bone tumor, accounting for 85 to 98% of all bone tumors of the limbs. It has no known cause. It was proposed that repetitive injury to the bone, virus, and genetic predisposition could potentially cause an osteosarcoma. It is usually a disease of large to giant breeds of dogs. Reported predisposed breeds include boxers, Dobermans, golden retrievers, German shepherds, Great Danes, Greyhounds, Irish setters, Irish Wolfhounds, Labrador retrievers, Rottweilers, St. Bernards, and Weimaraners. Lameness and localized limb swelling are the most common signs. This pain and lameness are caused by microfractures, disruption of the periosteum with tumor extension, and pathologic fracture. It usually occurs in the metaphyses of long bones, being the radius and humerus, the most common sites for osteosarcoma. It can also occur in the tibia, femur, toes, and hip. Usually the thoracic limb is more frequently affected. So when you have a dog limping, it is very important that this dog is submitted to an orthopedic examination to localize the source of the lameness and differentiate it from other similar disease. Complete a good physical examination as well, and complete a blood count, biochemistry profile, and urine analysis to evaluate general health. The second step is as important as the orthopedic exam, and it is to perform good x-rays, and if there's any doubt on evaluating these x-rays, please ask a person from diagnostic imaging to take a look. In an osteosarcoma, you should see bone lesions, which means that there's bone destruction, bone proliferation, the Codman's triangle, so the lifting of the periosteum that you can see here in this image. Loss of the normal pattern of the bone, and in some cases you can see also signs of fractures. Fibrosarcomas and chondrosarcomas are pretty similar to an osteosarcoma in an x-ray, and also fungal osteomyelitis, so it is important to perform a thorough anamnesis to know if the dog has traveled to a place where fungal disease is endemic. So, to differentiate a primary bone tumor from metastatic and fungal osteomyelitis and confirm the diagnosis of the osteosarcoma, it is recommended a fine needle aspiration or a biopsy. The first one is less sensitive, but is also less invasive. The second one has a risk of fracturing the bone and also lead to contamination of health tissues, but has a 95% success rate for diagnosis of osteosarcoma. The osteosarcoma is a very, very aggressive tumor known to kill more than 60% of dogs because of metastases. However, only less than 15% of dogs have detectable metastases at the time of diagnosis, usually in the lungs or other bones. To exclude a potential pulmonary metastases, we should perform triplane chest x-ray, so right and left lateral and ventrodorsal or dorsoventral. A thoracic CT is often a better choice to exclude tiny lung metastases. Also consider performing other x-rays of other bones to exclude bone metastases. Depending on the information we gathered so far about this dog, we have two options. So we can either opt for a palliative treatment or curative treatment. Palliative treatment is indicated for dogs with metastases or when the owner doesn't want to pursue more intensive treatment options. In this case, we only make the dog comfortable without increasing his survival time. We give medication to manage the pain and lameness, so analgesic drugs. We can also try palliative radiation therapy. It is usually effective, relatively inexpensive, and does not require prolonged hospitalization. It reduces the local inflammation, minimizes the pain, slows the progression of the metastasis, and improves the quality of life of dogs with osteosarcoma. Radiation therapy is more commonly used for palliative treatment, but it can also be used for control of the bone tumor where surgery is not indicated or refused by the owner. As parts of the palliative treatment and also curative treatment in a dog that has no metastases, we can amputate the limb that is affected by the osteosarcoma. In a dog with bone fracture and lameness unresponsive to analgesic drugs, amputation is very effective as a pain management, but only if the dog is a good candidate for amputation. For example, if it is an obese dog, it may not be a good option to amputate the leg. Usually dogs have a fast recovery and are able to walk in three legs in the same or the next day after surgery. We can opt for surgery but with sparing of the limb, usually because of owner reluctance to amputate the dog's leg. Candidates for this procedure are dogs with involvement of less than 50% of bone length, with tumors confined to the bone and with minimal extension into adjacent soft tissue. After resecting the tumor, the left part is filled with an implant. Good limb use is achieved in more than 75% of dogs, and complications that could arise are implant failure, local tumor recurrence by incomplete resection or residual neoplastic cells, and also infection. Curative surgery is always combined with chemotherapy to treat both the primary and potential metastases. So metastases are the most common cause of death in dogs after treatment. As I said, lungs and other bones are more frequently affected by metastases, but many other tissues can be involved. Poor prognostic factors in dogs with osteosarcoma include dogs younger than 7 years old or older than 10 years old, weighing more than 40 kilos, with a large tumor volume, proximal humeral location, with increased alkaline phosphatase activity, so ALP, that fails to normalize within 40 days of surgical removal of the tumor. High tumor grade, so tumors that grow quickly, and presence of metastases. To resume, osteosarcoma is a very, very aggressive tumor and the death rates are high. It is very important to discuss the best treatment option with your vet and ways to make the dog comfortable without the pain, and that it has a good quality of life. So once again, if you have any questions, please leave a comment below, and if you like this video, please like and subscribe. So thank you.